the PitView platform series. It's my pleasure to bring you this introduction to the FX PairView window, understanding the frontside controls, including MT4 chart interaction controls and FX PairView net percent versus weighted net percent analytic views. Your learning objectives for this lesson are to learn the 12 frontside controls on the FX PairView window and how to access 24 more controls through the right-click menu, which we cover in another video. 2. Understand the variety of ways these controls can help you enhance your FX PairView and PitView experience so you can more efficiently focus upon discovering excellent trading opportunities. 3. See the versatility for changing currency pair symbols, working with trade tickets, associating with other PitView windows, using heatmaps, and switching from LP to totals views. 4. Learn how to use PairView to control your MT4 chart. And 5. Understand the difference between net percent and weighted net percent views. This is the first introduction of weighted net percent in our video series, so we encourage you to pay special attention to this, for it is very interesting and can actually enhance your PairView experience. With no further ado, let's begin. Hello and welcome to this video on the FX PairView window by PitView. This video is on the front side controls, interaction with your MT4 chart, and the difference between net percent and weighted percent values with PitView. And just to remind everybody, here I have an FX PairView window, and up here I have my control bar. And just to remind everybody, I'm going to close the window, and we click right here to open a new FX PairView. We can open up to 3 of these windows if we want. I'm going to close these next two here. Okay, so explaining the front side controls for this window. In the upper left, we have the icon for the window for PairView that matches the one on the control bar. And then we have number 1 indicating instance 1 of 3. Some entitlement levels allow one of these windows or 3. Institutional entitlements may allow more. Then we have here the symbol pair name. This is for Aussie dollar, Swiss franc. It tells you it's an FX PairView window. And it says PitView for Forex. Now, if we double click on this title bar, the FX PairView window changes its form to show only the totals row. And if we double click again, it returns to showing the liquidity providers. And of course, we can grab the bottom of the window and move it up and down to decide exactly how many liquidity providers we want to show. And as I've said before, I like to show any with more than 1% of the total percent of activity. So this here symbol selector dropdown allows you to switch currency pairs. Here I've selected the Aussie New Zealand. You'll notice my chart changed. Also, my associated PitView trade ticket changed. You can see it's showing Aussie New Zealand also. And the way to know which is associated is to look at this particular selector. As we've covered before, this is the group selector, and you can associate any of your PitView windows with each other by putting them in the same color group. By default, when you start the program, all window instances number 1 are in the same color group, although you can change them each selectively as you like. So this particular icon is the trade ticket icon. You'll notice it matches the icon on the title bar of the trade ticket and in the PitView toolbar. And if I click it when that associated trade ticket is open, it will close it. So this is a great way to get the trade ticket out of the way and bring it back while you're looking at the PairView window, because you only really need the trade ticket when you're ready to enter a trade. So with one click, we can close and reopen the trade ticket. So this icon here allows you to match the time frame that is showing in this FX PairView dropdown. This is the time frame selector, and it will push that time frame to your MT4 chart if the linking to MT4 chart here, it has the orange background. Now we can click that orange background button and it opens the link to MT4 chart box here, and you can either turn linking on or confirm leaving it on, or you can turn it off. Here, I'll turn it off. Now you see it doesn't have the orange background. And now I'll turn it back on. It does have the orange background. Now, however, let's move over here for a moment. You'll see that I have M30 selected for my MT4 timeframe in the MT4 timeframe selector, and that's what the chart already says. But for instance, had I set my MT4 chart to say 4 hour, which I'll do right here by clicking the MT4 toolbar, now you can see that I have a 4 hour chart. Now this button allows us to change it back just by clicking here. That makes it very simple to control the time frame on your MT4 chart. Also, if you want to switch timeframes while you're still linked, you just simply use the selector, and picking a new time frame also pushes it. There, I've switched to 1 hour and 1 hour. I'll come back over here. Okay, the next area are the columns and rows, and we went over that in the other video, but I'll just go over it briefly. Liquidity provider ID, total percent. Total percent is the amount of time each liquidity provider has been active. This is a measure of their control of the market. And you can see that LPID 35 has controlled the market for 31.02% of the past 30 minutes, looking back from the current moment. The next three columns that are displayed by default are leaders, followers, and totals. And we have gone over that we have additional columns. You can select them here with the show hide columns. We've covered that in other videos as well, especially the one that deals with time frame selection and sessions and changing columns. This scroll bar, if you have a compact view, allows you to scroll through the liquidity providers without changing the size of your window. Now down here on the left, one that a lot of people don't notice, this is the heat map selector button, and we can switch it. This is now a 5-color heat map, and then you can push it to go to 10-color, and we can go back to 2-color. 2-color just has green for positive net percent values and red for negative net percent values, so you can tell at a glance what side each market maker is on and their leaders, followers, and total activity. With 5 shades, it's separated in gradations of color. Every 20% is a different shade of that color, green or red. And with 10 frames, every 10% is another shade of color. You'll notice that we have the same heat selector map in the FX total view window. It's the same icon, and it does the same function. I personally prefer a 10-color heat map, as do the other people here at PitView. It just gives you more information at a glance. And that's what we ship it in as a default. That's what it's set on as by default. Again, we've covered that the numbers in this totals row for net percent are the same ones that are placed in the FX total view window for the corresponding symbol. So let's switch symbols here. I'm going to pick the New Zealand US dollar. You'll see it's highlighted in yellow, the counterparties. And now I'm going to switch the total view window to the net percent view, and you'll see that the numbers here come precisely from the same column, the leaders column, because we're showing 1 hour leaders, 1 hour leaders, 26.9, 26.9, same numbers. So we've covered that. Okay, everybody, I had to take a break there. I've switched the symbol pair to US Canadian. Now there's one other button on this FX pair view window that we've never covered before. And it's this one in the lower right. And you'll notice in the total view window, we did cover this, and we used the same icon button to switch between the actual currency pair counterparty names and the net percent values, so you can see the values behind the names. Well, similarly, in the FX pair view window, we use this switcher to change the data, but we switch it in a different way. By default, it's on N, which is net percent, and you can tell when you're hovering your mouse pointer over the column headings that we have leaders, last minute's net percent, followers, last followers net percent, and last minute leaders and followers combined net percent. By last minute, we mean we're in a minute view, and whether it said 1 to 30 minutes, that's what the tooltip would say. I'm gonna switch it to hours. And now it just says session leaders, because sessions are 1 to 24 hours. And that's an artifact from a previous version of the software. We'll probably change that again in the future, like I've said before. In any case, when we're seeing this, we're seeing the net percent values that get translated over the total view window. However, we also decided that when you're looking at the liquidity providers and you're seeing the percentage of market activity each one has, we could actually weight their position, their net percent position, by multiplying it times the percent of the activity that they have. That gives them a weighted contribution to the market maker activity on the buy-sell bias. So I'm going to switch this, and it says in the pop-up, push to show liquidity provider buy-sell weighted percent values. So when it's in this red W, that's what we have. So here the numbers have changed. I'm going to go right back. Actually, I'll open up another FX pair view window so you can see the numbers side by side. And let's get this on the same time frame. So this is on a 1 hour, 1 hour. Let's get it on the same symbol, US Canadian. Are we looking at the same information? Okay, 1 hour leaders, and we're on the N view, and this is the W view. So look here, the weighted net percent is the total percent, which is this column, total percent, times the net percent for the corresponding variable, be it leaders, followers, or totals. So we multiply this 34.97 times this negative 28.26, and that comes to negative 9.97. I'm adding this brief edit. Keep in mind that the total percent column are percents. So when you multiply 35 times 28, you're really multiplying 0.35 times 28. And that is why the result is smaller as negative 9. It's roughly making it about a third as much in this case. And likewise, 23.90% times 29.14. And that comes to 6.68. So instead of these numbers looking almost identical, 28 negative, 29 plus, we break it down here. Now you can see that this one is actually a third greater in impact than this one, even though they look like they're the same numbers here. So there is a third setting for this button. And you notice the pop-up says push to show liquidity provider buy sell net percent heat map over the weighted values. When we push this, it's going to take the heat map from the net percent view as shown on the left and superimpose it over the weighted values on the right. And this way you kind of get both information sets at the same time. So before I push this button, notice the numbers here. And when I push the button, you're going to see that the numbers stay the same and now the heat map matches the one on the left. And notice it says C, but it's got a different color. So instead of the C that he used here for currency pair and counterparty names, here it means color heat map. So you have three settings of this. Again, N is the default, the net percent. This is what everybody usually uses it on. And then this is the weighted net percent. Again, the totals row times the net percent from the N view. And again, the color heat map on top of it. Now, some people get confused with their pair view because they may have this setting not the way they wanted it at certain points, and thus it can be confusing. I personally don't know whether I prefer just the net percent value or the weighted, and we have users of our program that prefer one over the other. But whatever the case is, if you ever get confused because the analytics here are not matching the analytics in your total view window when you go to the net percent view, it's probably because you have this weighted percent setting set. And that can provide some confusion, especially if two people aren't seeing the same screen and one of them has this set and the other one doesn't. So keep that in mind. That's an area that some people can get confused. That concludes our tour of the front side controls for the FX PairView window. We encourage you to watch our other videos on changing your timeframes and sessions and showing and hiding your columns. That's one video. And then we're making another video on the right-click menu in general. And you'll notice that PairView has a long one, TotalView has a shorter one, your trade ticket has another one. All of our windows have right-click or context-sensitive menus to allow you to do certain functions that you might want to access quickly. And of course, we try to make these as user-intuitive as possible by putting them in English for you. But we do encourage you to watch our next video on this. Thank you. May you use PitView to trade with success. Thank you for watching this introduction to FX PairView, understanding the front side controls, including MT4 chart interaction controls and FX PairView net percent versus weighted net percent analytics views. We hope this video will help you on your path to trading success, and we encourage you to watch the continuing series of the PitView platform series, as well as making use of our PitView University to learn from expert traders how they use PitView on their path to trading success.